Brandon Krause, here at your gym, Outlaws Boxing, Tarzana. Anthony Joshua, one of the best heavyweights in the world today, top five best heavyweights. Again, Dominic Brazil, when represented U.S. in the Olympics. Dominic just beat a very tough fight. He beat Amir Mansour. Why are you laughing? That was a tough fight, and he won.
I mean, it was a tough fight for him, but I don't know if it should have been a tough fight. And then, you know, this guy that struggled with Amir Mansour is now going to go fight Anthony Joshua.
In 1 week from tonight.
Yeah. So I think... What do you think? Everybody watching at home knows how that.
Dominic Brazil's gonna knock him out.
I would love Dominic Brazil to do well. He seems like a super nice kid.
He is a great kid.
And but I don't think so. No, I think Joshua's gonna take it. And I don't think it's gonna be that tough.
What round?
Fifth.
Yeah, maybe second.
It's gonna be a very tough fight, no question. But if you could win, in England, was that how big of an upset?
I don't think it's gonna be a tough fight.
Why?
I just don't think Dominic puts enough on his jab. He fights long, but doesn't fight with the intensity that a long puncher should fight with. And I just think Joshua's just got another higher level set of skills right now.
Agreed.
If Dominic Brazil does win, how big of an upset is that? How big of a shocker is that?
Well, here's the thing about the heavyweight, right? Any kind of lightweight fight, and somebody who's not slated to win wins, it's much more of an upset. You know, Dominic can hit. And if you get hit by him, then you go down. That could, what a shocker. No, you get hit by a heavyweight. And if it happens, it can happen early. You can get surprised. That's how boxing is, right?
I read somewhere that Tyson Fury has been dropped 3 times in sparring by a smaller sparring partner.
So?
He's fighting Klitschko.
Means nothing.
You know, watching the Tyson Fury and the Klitschko face-off, the English version, and now seeing we're going to be hard-pressed to find a character quite as bizarre and awesome, in my opinion.
I won't miss him. Flush him down the toilet. Done.
Tyson
Fury. I hope
Fury.
He's gone.
It's great,
I hope
man.
It's his last fight. I hope we never have to hear or see from him again.
He really is getting under Klitschko's skin.
Now, here's the thing about sparring.
Yeah.
It don't matter to me that he got dropped by a smaller man, because he's not fighting a smaller man.
Uh-huh.
The other thing is you do not know what his trainer put him in to work on.
Yeah, it's true.
So we put people in and we have a sparring partner that's not really capable of really pushing us. I'll make my fighters work on something in particular. Stand the jab, champ, nothing the jab. I don't want any right hands. I don't want the straight right you've been relying on it too much. I want hooks.
Work on blocking the shot or something.
Yeah, so we make them work on something so it's not surprising when they mess up. When they mess up, I don't give them a hard time. Wow, you got dropped and everything. Hey, yeah, we're working on something. Get right back up. Just keep trying it. Don't stop trying it. So sometimes it takes a lot of guts to try something new, to not do well, get dropped
okay.
Sometimes.
Tyson.
That means shit in the ring, though, when the fight comes. Not nothing. Whatsoever.
Tyson Fury against Anthony Joshua. Who wins?
I think Joshua's going to take that, too.
Why?
I think Tyson Fury would try the same kind of little sloppy shit against an older man. I don't think that's going to work against a younger man. I think the reaction time's too quick. I think he gets caught with a decent shot. I think he clowns and looks good for a little while, and then he gets tagged.
Puts the hands behind his back and sticks his chin out.
Does something stupid, and it's over.
All right, there you have it. Coach Cliff here at Outlaws. FaceAndrewPoint.com. Millie Sickback reporting.